Okay, what a night. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight was insane. Tonight was insane, guys. Half the time, I was literally watching the first pool party of the season with my jaw on the floor. Guys, Adekunle kept on shocking me. Adekunle was doing a lot of things. As a matter of fact, what Adekunle had actually told us to expect on the day of the launch show was what we got tonight. Adekunle told us ahead of time that we should expect bad boy Dex this season. And guys, that was what we got. Adekunle delivered. Oh my God. Guys, I don't think, like, see, never ever have I in my wildest imaginations even thought that Adekunle would be this free at a pool party. Guys, this never happened during the Level Up season. Mm-mm. This never happened. The amount of joy, the amount of freedom, the amount of expression I saw Adekunle display today. Ah, guys, it felt good to watch. And there's a lot more to say. Adekunle was whining and dancing and grinding with different ladies tonight. And guys, hey, my eyes are on that young man. I am keeping my antennas alert because, hey, these housemates are about to play a game and I cannot wait to see how this game is going to pan out tonight. Now, aside Adekunle, who was having the time of his life tonight, there was also Ilebae that was playing some sneaky games tonight. Guys, hey, see, I'm enjoying this, our smallio, but this girl is biting more than she probably can chew. And I cannot wait to spill the tea, guys. This girl was literally doing a lot. Hey, I'm gonna tell you about it. And then there was Alex and Pere. Guys, the way those people were grinding tonight. Hey, and Pere did not just stick to Alex. Pere would be with Alex, and then from time to time, you would see him and Uriel gravitate towards each other. Guys, guys, a lot was going down tonight. So, you know what? Just watch to the end of this video as I spill all the juicy tea, all right? And guys, as usual, I want to encourage you all to go ahead and share with me your thoughts in the comment section below. And officially, you especially welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Gloria Elijah. This is Frankly Speaking with Gloria Elijah, and I am the girl with the tea. Please do not hesitate to do exactly what you see on your screen if you are yet to subscribe to this channel, all right? Now, quickly, let's get into it. Now, for those of you that do not follow me on Twitter, you totally need to follow me on Twitter because I put my spur of the moment reactions about the show on there. Now, why am I making reference to Twitter? There were so many things I tweeted tonight about how the party panned out, especially about how Adekunle was, you know, just in his element tonight. Guys, I saw a different side to Adekunle. If you all recall, during the Level Up season, Adekunle never really did have this much fun in the house. Every pool party, Adekunle is always in one corner. The guy is moody. The guy is looking sad. And you just couldn't really blame him 100%. I mean, because back then, the tension in the house was crazy. The negativity was just way too much. But tonight, this guy was just shining in all of his glory. This guy was having so much fun. The party was so mature. Music was great. Food on point. Kidiwaya, is it Kidiwaya? Be Kidiwaya. Kidiwaya was the grill master of tonight. Cross, Cross was over the moon with joy. Guys, I put out a video earlier telling you all about, you know, Cross's complaints that he was feeling confused in the house. He was bored. He wanted to party. He wanted alcohol. He wanted to get intimate with someone. He wanted to just get wild. He wanted Cross the boss to come out. And guess what? Big Brother delivered tonight, yes, as there was a lot of alcohol to go around for all the housemates. And so Cross the boss came out to play, and Cross was having so much fun. Now, still on Adekunle, Adekunle's mood tonight was just very infectious. Guys, I was where I was, and I was just smiling. I was just happy seeing Adekunle enjoying himself, having the time of his life. And he could dance with literally any and everybody. He danced with Alex, danced with Venita. Hey, let's not forget about Adekunle's thing with Uriel. Guys, at this point, I'm suspecting that Adekunle is the young man that Uriel told Big Brother about during a diary session that she had a crush on. Biggie had actually asked her the name of the person, but she refused to mention. And then tonight, Adekunle had danced with Uriel. By the time he went into the pool, Uriel had followed suit. And they had had a very, very brief, steamy moment. And guys, I was watching these people like, what the hell is going on? I mean, they were very close to each other, but also I was kind of confused because after Uriel came out of the pool, you know, from time to time she would dance on her own, she would dance with other people, and then she would go and dance with Perry. And guys, I had mentioned on one of my videos earlier that I suspect strongly that there's this, you know, this tension, this chemistry between Perry and Uriel. Guys, you can't miss it. You can't miss it. It's right there in your face. If you look closely, you will see it. But then I still could not overlook the attraction going on between Adekunle and Uriel. Guys, my eyes are on these people moving forward. Now, let's talk about Ilebaye for a bit. Before the pool party, whilst everybody was preparing, Ilebaye had, you know, had conversations with White Money Fraud. There was doing in the picture at some point. Remember earlier I had informed you all that Ilebaye had shot her shot at White Money. She had professed her attraction towards him, her likeness for him. She had said that she was into him. She found him handsome and sweet and whatever. She wanted to be his girlfriend. And White Money had told Big Brother and Fraud, his friend, that he likes the girl as a younger sister, so he was going to give her space. You know, he was going to avoid her so as not to mislead her because he wasn't really, you know, interested like that. So Ilebaye has been really pushing. And so tonight, she kept on pushing and pushing and pushing. Now, before she joined the room, White Money was already having conversations with Fraud, and Fraud was kind of skeptical. Even Ike was there. Ike was like, he would never ever again believe anything in Big Brother's house. Yes, and I know he was speaking out of his experience with Mercy Eke. And that was when Ilebaye had actually joined the conversation. So she was sounding so serious, talking about how much she liked White Money. She had always, you know, had a crush on him right from outside the house. There were negative impressions about him, but she had actually encountered White Money before and the guy had actually taken care of him. And she had seen otherwise that, okay, this guy is not really a bad person. So she had started liking him. Now, guys, the way Ilebaye was telling all of this cap, I call it cap because I just feel strongly that that guy is lying. These guys, they were kind of, you know, almost convinced. Now, initially, Fraud was telling White Money, you know, not to take her serious like that. But, you know, when they go out of the house, he should test her to see if she's being serious. But then the moment she came into the room and she was saying a lot of things, even already giving White Money the label, the title of her boyfriend, you know, they were now confused. But White Money was just laughing. The guy was laughing. For him, he wasn't really interested. But all the guys kind of admired Ilebaye's audacity. They were even asking her, oh, where is your bikini? Other girls have worn theirs. And she was like, no, she's not going to show her bikini yet until her boyfriend approves, blah, 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 blah. Anyways, fast forward to the pool party. The moment they went outside, guys, Ilebaye jumped on Fraud. These two people were dancing erotically. They were whining. They were grinding. It was insane. And White Money and Fraud, they were seeing everything. So they were sitting on the swing and then they were watching everything that was, you know, happening, and they were having this deep, intense conversation. Now, we could not really hear what they were saying, but it sounded very, very serious. And in the midst of all of that, never for once did Ilebaye even bother to go and talk to her so-called boyfriend. Now, after dancing with Fraud and with Cross and even Perry at some point, she and Neil were engaged in a very, very lengthy conversation in the pool. And I was wondering, like, what are these people talking about? It was after the pool party that I overheard Neil, you know, having conversations with Tolani Badge. And it seemed as though Neil and Ilebaye had actually crossed paths before on the outside. And guys, honestly, I don't really understand the gist, but it seemed like they were probably supposed to, you know, probably be together and it did not work out. I don't know. I'm going to get more information about that and then fill you all in on that gist, because that gist is juicy. But overall, the party was rich. The housemates had fun. Everybody was having a good time. The housemates were relieved that at least for the first time in weeks, they were having fun. So they decided that they were going to play some games of probably truth or dare or any other one that everybody in the house was interested in playing. Ladies and gentlemen, just stay tuned. I will bring you all more juicy information, more juicy tea. All right. Thanks for watching and have an amazing night's rest. Bye.